Join me as I do some night photography here in Japan and this crazy cool weather where the rain is almost turning into snow, something I was not expecting. But you'll get to see why I love doing night photography in Japan and some of the characteristics of the street that I look for, how I approach it. And I'll also share, as you would have seen already, which camera I used, which film if I shot on film. And today's video sponsor is Nissi Filters, who provided me with the Black Mist filter kit. These are diffusion filters, which I find are perfect to have in your toolbox for doing night photography. So I like to experiment with using those filters. Sometimes I'll take shots with the mist filters, sometimes without, or I might even do both for the sake of this video so you can see the difference. But it's going to be quite varied. Here in Tokyo, the streets at nighttime, up in the mountains, in the snow, and hopefully we'll come up with some interesting stuff on both film and digital, and you'll get to explore a little bit of Japan at nighttime in case you haven't actually been here, and hopefully it'll tempt you to come out and enjoy this photographer's playground, especially if you like night photography. So thanks for joining on this one, and I hope you enjoy it.
As with most trips to Japan, we started in Tokyo, where one of the first temptations is to hit the hotspots like Shibuya. And as someone who loves street photography with people being the main subject, I of course couldn't help but do some of that during this trip. Tokyo is a hustling and visually aesthetic metropolis, with no shortage of activity and interesting stories, characters, and moments. But for this trip, I wanted to lean a little more into the quiet scenes, the back streets, and the places themselves, with people playing a secondary or only implied role in the photographs. Slowing down affords you the ability to contemplate the scene more thoroughly and find points of interest that you might otherwise miss in the darkness of night. During this trip, I tried Mr. Negative's 35mm Fuji Eterna 250T. This is a rare and expired cinema film available as cold stored stock from the Melbourne-based business, processed as ECN2 and scanned on a Fujifilm scanner. I think it was a great combination for these images, and a cool opportunity to be able to shoot a professional grade Japanese motion picture film in my stills camera in 2024. Shooting on a tripod is always a nice change of pace, and these images felt like a great warm up for the trip. This was one of my favorite shots from the first two nights. I find there's a certain visual appeal to the streets of Japan at night, and the way that artificial lights render on film. When doing long exposures, I usually stop my lens down for more depth of field and use a shutter release cable to avoid vibrations. Both advisable techniques when you want to maximize detail. But this trip was just getting started, and we were due to head up to the mountains of Yuzawa the next day.
So this is the part I was quite looking forward to for night photography here in Japan. Up here in Yuzawa, in the mountains. However, it's been snowing pretty relentlessly since we got here, which is amazing in its own way for the scenery. As you can see, the roads covered with snow and also the buildings and cars, just creating that extra layer, no pun intended, of interest and dynamic to the images. And last night I walked around this area shooting some images on digital on the Canon R6, which is filming me right now. But tonight I used last night's scouting to figure out some shots that I want to take on film because I think they could look really good. But what a beautiful night it is. I'm going to try and at least set up one scene, get one shot, and then probably head back in because it's a little bit tricky working in these conditions with all the snow. But hopefully we come back with something good. So I'm currently walking over to this late night ramen restaurant that I took a shot of on digital last night, and I'm gonna try and shoot it on the Eterna. So this is kind of the composition I'm going for here, with the restaurant as the central focal point and a little bit of this road trailing off there just for a bit of background interest. I'm gonna shoot it on the Voigtlander 28mm, stop it down a bit just to make sure I get plenty of depth of field. But I like having this light back here, which will contrast with the warm tungsten lights of the restaurant and create a nice color contrast between both sides of the image. So I've bracketed a few shots between 20 and 40 seconds, but I think somewhere between 20 and 30 seconds is good. And I just took this second composition from this angle as well. So I also quite liked this composition last night with the various lights on in these houses and the little bit of the truck popping out over there. I shot it on digital, but I just shot this tonight as well on the Eterna with about a 30 second exposure. It was giving me about 20 seconds on the digital camera test, but I went with a bit more for reciprocity. So I'm looking forward to seeing how this one turns out. But I think these two compositions are enough for tonight. My fingers are pretty much frozen, so I'm just gonna call it a night, pack up the Leica and head back.
The majority of our time in this region was spent up in the nearby resorts snowboarding during the daytime. The Niigata region of Japan is a great place to visit, and I found a vintage feel to many of the buildings and signage, as with many ski resort towns. I'd finished the roll of Eterna at our accommodation and loaded some Velvia 100 slide film in the daytime. After a day of snowboarding, I was in the central town area of Echigo Yuzawa, waiting for it to get dark.
So I just did an exposure of this ramen shop, which is actually just called Ramen Shop, on Velvia 100 in the Leica with a 28mm lens. But I quite like this scene, and I think the mist filter will add to that glow to give that feeling of warmth and atmosphere that is already present in the ramen shop. Let's see how this one turns out. We've definitely got that blue sky up there now.
I think this shot works a lot better, and it shows the importance of waiting for that blue hour sky to match the brightness of the interior artificial lights. And that's one of the things I enjoy about night photography. There's so much variation you can create while balancing different sources of light within a scene. And the results will further vary depending on your exposure, lens choice, filters, and so on. All of this creates room for more experimentation. I went back to the restaurant to get a few more exposures there before calling it a night and heading back. While walking around the next day, I found this Lawson convenience store and decided to come back and shoot it at blue hour, when the interior lights would come on. I had loaded a roll of Mr. Negative Fujifilm 64D earlier that day, and figured that a long exposure would work well taken from the service station across the road. Now it was just a matter of waiting for the post-sunset blue hour.
YouTube の動画撮っている。オーストラリアから。すごくいい写真ね。ありがとうございます。So I'm just setting up here for a shot of this Lawson convenience store on the Fuji Eterna 64D that I got from Mr. Negative. So this should work quite well because of the ambient light outside the building about now matching the light, the interior light from the convenience store. So it's almost blue hour. It's a bit of a pale blue hour, but I'm gonna just try and quickly get this shot and also add the Nissi 1/8 black mist filter because I think that'll add a little bit of a soft glow to the interior lights to give it a little bit more of a dreamy vibe. All right, so I've set up my composition and we're going with the straight on, the Nick Carver, because I don't know what else would work here. And I really want to get those mountains in the background and the blue sky. And I'm going to take my first shot now, f5.6, about 1 second overexposing slightly. So maybe exposing the Eterna at 50. And we'll see how that comes out. I might even do one without the mist filter for comparison so you can have a look at the difference between the two. And the way I'm metering this is I'm doing a reflected metering of the light from the store and the sky, which currently are just about matching, which is good. But I might even wait for the sky to go an even deeper blue, just so you can see how much of a difference this makes with evening and night photography as to the change in the color of the sky. Yeah, hopefully the shot will come out all right. It's nothing too special, but it's just fun to do night photography and to enjoy the scene while you're out here waiting.
It was our last night in this region, and I managed to take a few more shots on the walk back that night. In hindsight, I could have overexposed some of the film shots a bit more for increased shadow detail, but I still like how they came out overall. When it comes to using diffusion filters, you probably don't want to use them for every shot, but sometimes they give a subtle lift to the atmospheric quality by softening the highlights. I mostly like to use the 1/8 strength to maintain this subtlety. Sometimes the quarter or half can work too, depending on the effect you're going for. And when I'm unsure, I just take a few variations of the scene, since night photography generally affords you the time. And that's where something like the Nissi Professional Black Mist Kit can come in handy in case you do want to experiment with different strengths. You can always buy them in a larger size and use stepping rings for smaller lenses. The next morning, it was time to head back to Tokyo for the last leg of our trip. I'll share a few more shots with you that I got during my outings at nighttime. It's not always suitable to take a tripod with you, so I like to sometimes make do by leaning on a wall or placing the camera on some kind of surface out on the street. Combined with a fast lens, this can work quite well. In the case of digital, things like in-body stabilization are nice, and of course the ability to use high ISOs. But the main thing I want you to take away from this video is to just use whatever suits you and the situation at hand, and to just get out and enjoy night photography. The world is a different place at night, and I find that photography always helps you notice and appreciate things that you otherwise might not. Whether it's Japan or somewhere else, be safe out there, and I hope you enjoyed joining along on this trip.